Ladies and gentlemen, guys and girls, people from all over the world, welcome back to the Den FM Daily, broadcasting live to your transmissions from the Gold Coast. Today, we have the Joshua Lynott. Where are you, my man? Here he is.
Here we go.
From Gold Coast to South Australia.
The boys are online.
The boys are on the line, mate. Talk us through the day. What's been happening?
Look, today took the morning very, very easy. Yep. My main priority this week is to just gather as much sleep as possible with the upcoming ultra marathon.
The ultra man,
that's me. And then big news is I am your latest Lululemon ambassador.
Oh, mate. Lululemon ambassador.
Yeah.
You're looking through it, mate. You're going to be repping some new kit over the next couple of weeks.
Over the next couple of years.
Oh, baby. Talk to me.
Lululemon.
Oh, man. That's unreal. Congrats,
Australia,
mate.
Australia, New Zealand.
So stoked for you.
We're going to be doing some things.
Oh, I love it. I love it, mate. All right. Well, look, for those people not tuning in, what's the ultra run you've got coming up?
What's it all about? The race is an 85-kilometer road race from the top of Bali, north in Lovina, down to the south. And yeah, so we run across Bali in the night just to avoid traffic, to kind of combat the heat a little bit. And every one of the competitors has to raise $7,500, and we're trying to raise $200,000 to put kids through school in Indonesia.
Mate, it's phenomenal. So for those, just to reiterate, 84 kilometres across the island of Bali.
85 this year.
most people go there to eat smoothie bowls and you go there to run across the island.
Yeah.
And eat smoothie bowls.
I'll be smacking plenty of smoothie bowls after the race.
But what you failed to mention there, mate, is you're actually, from what I understand, the defending champ. Is that correct?
Yes, that is true. But I'm heading back to defend my title.
So talk us through it. Last year, how did it go down? How did you feel, and what are you coming back for this year?
Well, last year I was the underdog, so right. there was no eyes on me, and yeah. I hadn't run more than 30 kilometers. People didn't think that I could run that far. Some people were like, "What are you doing? You're gonna put yourself at a big detriment." I was like, "I'm just gonna have a crack," and then 30 k's in, I found myself at the front, and then led for the next 54 k's.
So you're running from the front.
Yeah, ran from the front. Pretty early into the race, and I had over 50 k's of it solo. So.
And what was the preparation like last year compared to this year? Because I mean, I've been following a lot more consciously this year. And you're definitely putting the K's in the bank. But was it the same last year? Or?
Last year I only had 10 weeks notice before the race. I kind of signed up to the race with 10 weeks out. So, and I was only running maybe 50 K's a week at most last year, and got up to 90 K's a week. But now I've got a year behind me of, averaging over 80 K's a week, been knocking out 100, 110 a week this year. So,
mate, that's unreal.
Definitely collected a few more footsteps, heartbeats, KMs.
And you're all about building the foundations. You certainly laid them this year. Has that been the philosophy?
5:30.
Back to days, baby.
go slow. That's been the philosophy for the last year. Just work capacity, build the foundation slowly, and build up what you can do over time instead of just trying to throw yourself under the bus and hope for the best.
So last year you were just working purely from the mental game, would you say?
Yeah, but that was like a small running base.
Yeah.
But it was quite inconsistent. Whereas this year there's been, yeah, I've had a year of consistent training, which I've never had before. And yeah. It will be a different mental game this year, knowing that I'm fitter.
Yeah.
Which means I should probably conserve at the start.
Yeah. So you're going to go, we don't want to concede too many tactics here, but you are the hunted.
I am maybe the hunted this year, but there, Shawnee
Bell, he's got to have the hunter mindset though, isn't that right?
Yeah, exactly. Be first, but train as if you're second.
Oh, baby, write that down.
Write it down.
A lot of people that are just kind of thinking about getting into running, or they've got a running base, I think you've fully just blown the whole idea that you have to run fast to be fast out the window, because I've been following you for about a year on Strava now, and the only time I think I've seen you break like 4:45 pace is when you're pulling out a 16-minute 5K.
Yeah, run slow to run fast.
Where have you built that philosophy from?
One of the guys I run with, Michael Nitschke. Check him out. He's doing his master's currently. And he's just an absolute running guru, this guy. So I've learned a lot from him. And, yeah, every Thursday we run through the forest, talk about different training models and the reasons why people run fast or run slow. But the idea is if you run slow, you recover quicker. And if you recover quicker, you can run again earlier. The more you can run, the fitter you're going to get. So if you're just starting, go slower than you think.
Yeah. So always slower than you think. It seems so simple in theory, man, but I think it's a lot harder to actually do, especially on Strava where there's eyes on you and everyone's watching you training. It's easy to get caught up where you run with a few crew and it becomes a bit of a lad's race about who's running faster. Yeah.
Someone said to me the other day, when you finish a jog, you should, at the end of the jog, you should feel like you can go and do that again. So
there's something to work from.
Yeah, exactly. So if you're feeling cooked and can't do it again, well,
you've gone too hard.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you've put about a year in the bank of just solid racking up the K's for this event. We're 10 days out now. Talk us through the next 10 days. Where are we going?
Next 10 days. So the rest of this week, I'm just getting big sleeps, trying to get my 8, 9, 10 hours every night.
Huge, man. I reckon sleeping is underrated.
Oh, yeah. I really valued sleep a lot more this year. It's like someone said the other day, it's like sleep is the closest thing to like a legal performance enhancing drug.
Mate, I was just about to say, I think it's the best legal drug there is.
Yeah, exactly right. So,
yeah.
And if anyone actually wants a good podcast to listen to, listen to Joe Rogan. I think it's like episode 1107 or 1108. And he interviews a sleep expert, and you learn a lot on that one.
Because what's the theory behind that? That when you're sleeping, it's the most your body can recover.
It's just it's the best form of recovery. But from a performance perspective, you're gonna go into lactic earlier. You're just wear yourself out a lot quicker. Your body battles more. So I'm not talking very scientific stuff right now, but
science, bro.
Yeah.
All right. So we've got plenty of sleep. You're just going to be banking hours in the bed, resting the body.
Eating well, a few more
runs. What's the day in the life of a Josh Lynott diet? What are we talking? Are you mostly plant-based or are you the opposite?
Pretty much plant-based. I've been vegetarian now for 6 months, which has been huge.
And enjoying it?
Loving it. Feeling very light, slowly working towards 100% plant based, but we'll get there.
What's your weakness? What do you crumble for?
It's not so much what my weakness is. It's just if I'm on the road, I don't like to scrutinize everything.
Yeah. Just, yeah. And you don't need to put a title on anything too, just eating what's good.
Yeah,
but
exactly.
But run us through today. So you've had a good sleep. Do you wake up and have brekkie, or are you...
Wake up, had some peanut butter crumpets, actually.
Oh, baby. Yeah,
also, one of the boys has just chimed in and he said, what's your weakness? Chocolate milks. And
chocolate milk.
Yeah, he's got me there. He's got me. Yeah.
loves the chocky milk.
Yeah. huge chocky milk fan. And then, yeah, by lunch, it's usually like a bowl of greens, some kind of lentils, some fruit, smashing lots of tea. Currently.
Off the coffee.
I wasn't for a long time. Then I got into it for a couple of years, but because of the parasite I just recovered from, they said, get off that. So right now it's just like a very alkaline diet, lots of greens.
Yeah.
Trying to get just lots of probiotics in. So yeah, I've got a bit of yogurt going in at the moment, but
You're a picture of health. So we're at brekkie. Then we've done lunch. Sorry. So what are you lining up for dinner? A couple of kilometers in the bank on the track, and then
couple of kilometers, and then usually it's just like kale salad or spinach, sweet potato, just good carbs, or minestrone soup. Just as many. I'm just hunting for veggies.
Mate, it's a good place to be at home, just raiding the kitchen.
Yeah. I'm like, Mom, just help me out. What veggies can we get into me right now?
What do you like in the kitchen, mate? Side note.
Pretty useless currently.
Not offering a great deal.
Nah, breakfast, I'm a jet. After that, no good.
We've got a controversial point here, folks. So the other day I've gone live and I'm just in there just running through my smoothie bowl routine, and old Joshy Lynott just starts piping up with this spoon test. And I'm thinking, spoon test? What is he on about? And his philosophy is, you talk us through it. It's your philosophy. I'm a big fan.
So a smoothie bowl should be solid in its consistency. Otherwise, it's a juice, right? Yeah. I hate going to a cafe and you get a smoothie bowl and you can like pretty much just grab the bowl and drink it. That's not the idea. So it's called the spoon test. So you get it, and when you flip the spoon, there should be a bit of hang time. And if it just runs off, you got to add some more peanut butter.
Yeah. You're making a smoothie, bananas. Not a bowl.
Yeah.
Put it in a cup, not a bowl.
Yeah, exactly. There's a difference between a smoothie bowl, a smoothie, and a juice. You should be able to distinguish the difference between them.
All right. Well, those that are tuning in on the live, give us a thumbs up if you want to see next time Josh and I go live, we have a smoothie bowl contest. we put the friendship on the line.
I have a trademark recipe. And
he's calling it. Thumbs up if you want
to
see.
Willing to share it. Willing to share it for a victory.
Oh, mate, it's convincing. Next time we have a chat, you're gonna have to get it out, mate.
Oh, we have.
And you know what? I'm back. Low key, I'm backing myself in. I think I've got something up the sleeve that I might be able to trump it.
We've got plenty of thumbs up coming in there.
All right, mate. So that's next time. Anyway, so back to the preparation week. We've got the K's in the bank, eating well, sleeping well. What day are we heading over there? Are you getting over there early or are you flying in?
Heading to Perth on Saturday and just hanging out with the boys over there, and then to Indonesia on the 21st. So what's that, like a Wednesday next week or something? But another key part of the preparation was just being around great people. So
I'm
around the people that make me happy, just gives me confidence. So, and that's the biggest
good
thing.
Healthy headspace.
Yeah, because the work has been done 8 weeks out, 4 weeks out. So the last like month before a marrow or 8 weeks before an ultra is just having your confidence, really.
Yeah. And talk us through your ideology of the one percenters. And maybe you can relate that to your ultra.
Oh, alrighty. So yeah, 1% is kind of like my motto and a little tattoo on me. But it's like,
where is it? Where get it? Can we see it?
Oh, it's a bit wrapped up right now.
Mate, you got a couple of layers on. It's chilly down there in SA.
It is. No, I'm just trying to acclimatize to the heat, stay warm for Bali. But yeah, 1% is always appreciate the little things in life and always put in that extra little bit of effort, because I think the small things in life are infinitely the most important.
So, I love it, mate. I love it.
That's my motto. And to relate it to the race is, it's like getting the sleep, putting in the extra Ks or sticking to your program, just doing all the little things because they're going to add up. So, yeah, details.
It's the details. I think it's easily brushed over too, man. Like, it's so easy to look for the big grand successes for happiness, but there's little things in every day that can make you happy and they all add 100%. Up. 100 little things and you got 100%.
Yeah, there we go.
Awesome, mate. Well, thanks for your time and the quick little chat here.
Oh, mate, it was an absolute pleasure. And I can't wait for round two with the smoothie bowl.
Mate, I'm looking forward to it. We won't disrupt your preparation anymore. We'll have to wait till afterwards. But maybe we can get a little bit of tropical international action on the live and we can have the comp when you're in Bali after the race.
If I can get a blender or a food processor, we're on.
Maybe a little day in a smoothie bar. You can get behind the bar there and full access. I don't have the right against me. You with all the utilities.
I don't have the right utensils. Yeah, I need the utilities. I need the right tools or it's not happening.
Just or the odds important. Start to become a bit more even.
Yeah. What about you? What's on the training schedule today or tonight?
Oh, mate, I like to bank the work early in the day, get it done. I'm with you on the sleep at the moment, just really focusing on getting a good night's sleep, 9, 10, 11 hours. Boom. And then just roll into the pool, get the set done, and then a little ride out in the valley. Mate, you would love the valley. When you come up for a visit, mate, I'm telling you, it's like so peaceful. Oh, it's like kind of rainforesty, hinterland landscape, mountains, and just like fully immersed in nature, man. And no, there's never anyone out there. It's always so peaceful.
Just makes training so much fun.
What was that? Sorry?
Just makes training so much more worthwhile.
Mate, that's why we do it. It's places therapy. You can take your body in your own 2 feet. It gets me every time, man.
Every time.
But I'm in no shape to be running an Ultraman, Ultraman, that for sure, man.
It's all mental.
84Ks, I would actually break, man.
Nah, if you do a half iron or an iron, it's just a walk in the park for you.
Man, I need a bit more conditioning, I think. Give me another 12 months and I might meet you over there for a little contest.
A few more 5:30.
On the 5:30 train, baby.
Yeah, love it.
Is that sort of the pace we're looking at for a marrow?
Oh, look, won't spread too much info yet, but if we can hit
some
5:30s on the back end.
What did you average last year for 84K?
I think it was like 6:50. So
holy smokes, man.
Yeah.
That is moving for 84Ks.
So we'll see what we can do. But,
all right, so stay tuned, everyone.
Stay tuned for the back end of the ultra.
Back end of the ultra. Joshy, why not? Hopefully all the hard work's paying off. All the smoothie bowls in the bank, all the sleep, it's all going to add up.
And we can throw it down.
The 1%ers, baby, the 1%ers.
1%ers. Oh, mate, this has just been spectacular.
Yeah, I'm a big fan, mate. Really appreciate you joining us and having a chat.
Thanks for getting me up.
No, we'll touch base again soon after your race, kind of a little debrief, and then if you got the utilities there, we'll have a little smoothie bowl off as well.
Superb. Alrighty, speak to you soon, brother.
Alright, mate.
If anyone's got any questions about running, ultras, smoothie bowl recipes, you name it, just ping me a DM.
And check out his book if you haven't already. The
Why Don't You? Thoughts Worth Thinking.
Why Don't You? On your website, link in bio.
Yep. You're on it.
All right, folks. Click through. Check See out Joshy. See you, mate.
Gotcha.
Ah, thanks for tuning in, folks. Absolute ripper chat there with Joshy. That's another day in the bank, baby. We keep stacking the days here on the Den FM Daily. I'll put all the links to Joshy's stuff on the podcast, so make sure you click through, check him out, follow along for his journey. The Ultra is in 10 days, so super exciting times in the world of Josh Lynott. Also just signed up as a Lululemon ambassador, so give him a little DM, pat on the back, get behind him. Big week ahead for the great man. And once again, thanks for tuning in on the Den FM. I'll see you tomorrow. Peace and love.